In this chapter, we're going to add one final form of interaction, voice commands. We're going to add two kinds of voice commands. Global voice commands will trigger no matter what you're looking at, while gaze-aware voice commands will target just like the hand gestures based on the user's gaze. Go ahead and minimize Visual Studio. We're going to create a script now to manage the user's speech input and help route it, similar to the gaze gesture manager. Right-click on the scripts folder, go to Create C# Script, and name this script Speech Manager. Go ahead and drag the Speech Manager script up onto the Origami collection, and click the Origami collection to ensure the Speech Manager script appears. Now go ahead and double-click on Speech Manager to open that script up in Visual Studio. Replace the contents with the contents from this chapter. Similar to the Gaze Gesture Manager, we're going to register handlers for each command that we want to recognize. We're then going to use the gaze from the Gaze Gesture Manager to target that command at that particular hologram. You can see in the start method that we're registering the map between the strings that we want to recognize and the actions we want to take when those strings are recognized. We're registering two commands, one command for reset world. This is a global command that will trigger no matter what I'm looking at. And we're registering another command called drop sphere. This will be specific to one hologram. In the case of reset world, we're going to send the on reset message to every object in the scene. And in the case of drop sphere, we're going to figure out if there's a focused object using the gaze gesture manager, and we're going to send the on drop command just to that object. We then register these commands with the keyword recognizer and tell it to start recognizing. Later, when a phrase is recognized, we're going to go back to our map and invoke the action that matches that command. Make sure you save, minimize Visual Studio. Now we have our voice commands routed. Let's add the scripts that are going to recognize those commands. Now we'll modify the sphere command script to receive the commands routed by the speech manager. Go ahead and open up the sphere command script again and paste in the version that goes with this chapter. You can see that we still have onSelect to handle our hand gestures, but we now have an onReset and onDrop method. In the onReset method, we're going to go ahead and put the sphere back where it started. We're also going to remove the rigid body if it exists, so that it doesn't immediately fall again. And in the onDrop method, we're just going to do the same logic we did when there was a tap. Make sure you've saved, minimize, and then build and deploy your project as usual. Now you can use the voice commands that you've added in the emulator. Just go ahead and say reset world or drop sphere to your computer's microphone. We've now seen all three forms of input on HoloLens: gaze, gesture, and voice. We're now going to add spatial sound to our app so we can both see and hear our holograms. Thank you.